classification of size reduction equipment. In that, various types of equipments are used for the size reduction purpose, such as crushers, grinders, ultra-fine grinder, cutting machines. And these crushers, first is crushers in, for example, what are the crushers? Edge runner mill and end runner mill. Grinders are hammer mill, roller mill, attrition mill, ball mill. Also, ultra-fine grinder is the fluid energy mill, and cutting machine is the cutter mill. Then, next is the, here in this table, various types of mills and their mechanism of action is mentioned. Here, first is the hammer mill. It is operates on the principle of impact. Okay, and this mill is used for the ointments, slurries, dry materials, and also it is used for almost all the drugs. Then next is the roller mills. It is operates on the principle of attrition and compression, and it used for the soft materials, because in a roller mill two rollers are crush the material in between two rollers, and which compress the material. So it is only used for the soft materials. Then colloid mills operates on the principle of impact and attrition, and it is used for almost all the drugs and also brittle drugs. Next is the ball mill. Ball mill is operates on the principle of impact and attrition, and it is used for the milling dyes, pigments and insecticides. Next is the fluid energy mill. It operates on the principle of impact and attrition, and it is used for the moderately hard and friable materials, also used for the antibiotics and vitamins. So first mill is the hammer mill. This is the hammer mill. Okay, this is here principle and uses, construction and working. This is the hammer mill. In that, this mill consists of here, this is a hopper. Okay, here this is the milling chamber. In that, here a shaft is placed. Shaft is either vertical or horizontally placed. And here this blue colored shows hammers. Okay, these hammers are placed. These hammers are mounted on the shaft. Okay, at the bottom of this mill, here the screen is attached. Screen means here sieve like structure is attached for the product discharging. Here motor is attached for the operating the hammer mill. Okay, here in this hopper, firstly we discuss the principle of this hammer mill. What is the principle of this hammer mill? The hammer mill operates on the principle of impact, in that hammers are continuously moving and mounted on rotor and beat the material and gives the size reduction of material. Okay, this is the principle. And in the construction, this is the hammer mill. In that, mill can be either horizontally or vertically shaft type. Okay, and here the hammers are made up from hardened steel and stainless steel. The hammer impact surface made up from extremely abrasive resistant materials such as carbaloil and high stellite. Here stainless steel hammers are sufficient for pharmaceutical purposes with various shapes. Hammers are of two basic shapes. One is stirrup and second is bar shaped. And these bar shaped hammers are used for tablet granulation. It is used for the tablet granulation. The hammers are of two types. One is the rigid type and another is the swing type. The hammers are also consist of hammer blades. These blades are of two types. First is flat edged blades and other is sharp edged blade. In this mill, these both type of blades are used. And here at the bottom of the mill, here one screen is attached. This screen are removable screens, and these are not of a woven type. It possesses perforated holes or slots, and it is prepared by using metal sheets with various thickness. Okay, then what about working? In that, when mill is start, here when mill is start, then the hammers are continuously rotated, means it is in a continuous motion up to 8000 to 15000 revolutions per minute. Then material is placed in hopper, it is flows vertically, okay, it is flows vertically and then comes in and it comes in mill horizontally. Here at that time hammers are in a continuous motion and it rotating hammers beat the material and gives the size reduction of the material and produces smaller particles, and these particles comes here at the bottom and pass through this screen, okay, and pass through this screen here. Due to tangential exit, the size of particle is considerably smaller than aperture of the screen. This screen are interchangeable so that we can adjust any grade of screen here. Means if we want smaller size particles or very fine particles, then we adjust the screen as per requirement. Here in this mill, hammers are act as a centrifugal fan. Due to this, large amount of air is drained through mill. That's why heat is generated during milling process. Okay. And here we can adjust the fineness of product by rotor speed or feed rate or clearance between hammers and grinding plates, size of screen and number and type of hammers. Then what is the uses of this hammer mill? Okay, what are the uses of this hammer mill? This is the diagram of mill. This type of hammer mills are used in the industry. What are the uses? A hammer mill used for milling dry materials, wet filter press cakes, ointments and slurries, etc. For brittle materials, blunt hammers are used because brittle material, thisur, ek prakarcha thisur material, this material can be easily breaks, okay, for that purpose blunt hammers are used. For fibrous material, cutting edges are used, means hammer blades are used for cutting purpose, so it act as a knife. Then what are the advantages in that? It is easy to set up and clean up. It is versatile, means the hammer speed and bottom screen can be changed rapidly. आपल्याला कोणत्याही साईजचं मटेरियल पाहिजे असेल तर आपण काय करणार, त्या रिक्वायरमेंटमध्ये ती स्क्रीन आपण चेंज करणार. जर व्हेरी फाईन पार्टिकल पाहिजे असतील तर स्मॉल साईजची स्क्रीन तिथे अटॅच करणार. जर थोडे कोर्स पार्टिकल पाहिजे असतील तर थोडे मोठ्या साईजची सीव, म्हणजे जी काही स्क्रीन असेल, परफोरेटेड होल असलेली स्क्रीन, ती आपण काय करणार तिथं सेट करणार. हा झाला ॲडव्हान्टेज. ओके, ऑल्सो what are the disadvantages? The screens may be clogged, okay, the screens may be get clogged because heat generated during milling material get adheres on screen and it becomes clogged. Also heat build up during milling is more, therefore product degradation is possible. It means those material are thermolabile, which is heat sensitive materials, which becomes deteriorates. So product decomposition or degradation is occur. So it is the disadvantage of the hammer mill. Also wearing of mill and screen is more with abrasive materials. Also hammer mills cannot be used for sticky, fibrous and hard materials. Why? Because when we grind hard material, it requires more energy and power. So it produces heat during milling. Product degradation is occurs, and also due to heat a sticky material becomes soft and stick on the hammers and sews. Okay, that's why sticky material is not used. Also for fibrous materials, it requires proper cutting, so it can be reduced by using cutting operation, okay, by using cutting mills. So here in hammer mills, sticky, fibrous and hard materials can't be reduced. Okay, this all about the hammer mill.